First off, I want to thank the brave men and women who work behind the wall. I want to thank them on a national level because their job goes unrecognized.
How do they try to turn a guard?
Well, correctional officer. How you guys doing today? It's Anthony Gangi. Welcome to another episode of Tear Talk. Guys, I want to cover supervisors and their relationship with that logbook. Me and Gary York had a great discussion yesterday about documentation, and we crossed into logbooks, and we crossed into, briefly, supervisors. And there was a lot of points there that we covered, but that's a longer episode. So I want to pull some of those points out and present it here because I think it's very important. Also, guys, this video is sponsored to you by Guardian RFID. From inmate tracking and cell checks to cloud-based business and artificial intelligence, Guardian RFID digitally transforms jails, prisons, and juvenile detention facilities of every size. Visit GuardianRFID.com for more information. Now, there are some systems that may not use logbooks like we do, the old-fashioned logbooks. They could have something digital like Guardian RFID, a computerized system. But I do know that there are still a lot of facilities that do stick to that old-fashioned method. So I want to give some advice with that logbook. And most likely this advice here could be able to be carried out to the tracking side of things. But for the most part, I'm really focused on those old-fashioned logbooks. Now, one thing right off the bat, as a supervisor, I believe that you should be responsible for signing yourself in during those routine tours. One, it shows you were on site. That's your handwriting. It also shows that you saw what was above on the lines that, you know, were above yours when you signed your name. So basically, when you signed your name and said you were in that unit or in that area, it shows that you reviewed the lines before that. That's very key. That's what people are going to expect. Hey, when you signed the logbook, did you read the lines before that? Are you okay with the lines before that? If there's any discrepancy, what did you do? Because guys, these logbooks at any time can be requested to the highest of authority, from admin to executive staff to the courts. So when your name is in that logbook, they're going to expect you as a supervisor to review the information that was before. That's why I always tell people, you know, if you have an officer who is assigned that post and, you know, you're getting ready to sign, you see that there's some missing lines, or the officer says, hey, give me a few lines down and then you can go ahead and sign because I didn't get a chance to put this in. Don't sign it yet. Don't do it. Wait till the officer fills in those lines so you can review it and then sign it. Because if they put something in that may not be that good of a thing to put in, you just signed underneath it. So progressively, people are going to think that you saw that, you reviewed that, and you were good with it. Also, on another note, guys, the officers of those assigned areas, they are responsible for that logbook. That means at no time that logbook should leave their site. And if it does, it's secured. So if I'm an officer, I have to go do a tour, I'll make sure it's locked and secured, and I'm the one that has the key to it. Because again, during my shift, I'm responsible for the integrity of that logbook. So if I'm a supervisor and I'm reviewing the logbook, I usually review it somewhere in the vicinity of that officer so they can view what I'm doing. So God forbid, you know, if there's a change made or someone made a change, hey, that wasn't me. That wasn't me. You watched me viewing the logbook. You saw that all I did was look at the lines beforehand and I signed my name that everything was good when I came onto that post. Another thing is never take the logbook out of that officer's sight or the person responsible for it unless you got that higher level approval. And you better make note of that. Because again, that logbook is that officer's responsibility. It's their eyes on that logbook at all times. So once you take that logbook out of their sight, then they're no longer responsible for that time that it's not in their sight and their line of view. So you better have permission to do that. Those logbooks should never leave the vicinity of who is responsible ultimately for those logbooks, which is that officer in that assigned area or whatever assigned staff member. Whoever's assigned that area has that responsibility of that logbook. So that logbook should never leave their sight unless it's requested to do so from a higher level authority. That's a very big thing. And you better document that in the book, and you better document who requested for that to be off site. Now, my boy Joel Rodriguez also wants to make it clear on one thing. Now, I'm very adamant about pushing for the supervisors to sign themselves in. You know, I agree with that, especially on those routine tours. That's your signature. That's your handwriting. That shows that you've been on the unit. But if there's an incident that occurs and you're responding to something, then the officer or the person assigned that logbook can probably write everything in general. You know, a fight happened on the unit, on the scene is blah, 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 blah. And anytime there's a supervisor writing in that logbook or a supervisor present on the scene, they should be written in red. It's got to stand out. The supervisors in those logbooks have got to stand out for a quick reference. If you don't have a red pen, you know, worst comes to worst, black mark, black pen, blue pen, whatever it is, whatever your procedure is, highlight. Put a highlighter. It's got to be something that stands out. So when it could be quickly referenced. Now, sometimes supervisors could get tied up and there's a chance that they have to tour. But for some reason today, there's a code or something. I'm just tied up with paperwork. I can't make the tour. Call it in. And the officer will write that you called in and made a check. They're not going to say you were in the unit. Don't do that. That's falsifying documentation. They'll just say that you called and made a check. Again, guys, that is very, very important because even on the post I put on Facebook, that's falsifying documentation. Hey, I made a phone call to check on you. I'm sorry I couldn't get there. I'm tied up doing this, but can you just make sure you put in the logbook, Supervisor Gangi called the unit to check to see if everything was okay? Very, very important. So again, this was just something quick. Obviously, you have the specifics, time, dates. We all know that. That's 101. I just want to make sure that we protect ourselves. That logbook is so very important. It could save your career, but it could also end it. As always, guys, the show is tiered. If you haven't, please subscribe, interact, engage, comment, hit that bell. Bell's going to notify you every time I post a video. Stay safe.